This is the new Xiaomi 13T and the 13T Pro. Both looks the same, has the same Leica professional camera system, the same massive refresh rate, the same screen and the same battery capacity. So, what's different? Well, since you clicked on this video, I will tell you. So the difference in the unboxing process firstly is that the Pro comes with a higher 120 watts hypercharge adapter and the non-Pro comes with a 67 watts turbocharging. And when it comes to the build quality, the 13 Pro is slightly heavier, particularly for these two color variants. And based on me holding these two phones side by side, you can tell the difference. Then both MediaTek chipsets that the phone comes with are slightly different chips, but it has the same 4nm process. Now, while there's a tiny bit difference on the benchmark scores for the CPU, there's a huge difference in GPU scores, but this could be because of the higher RAM configuration that I have on the Pro, so I would take that with a grain of salt, but I will reveal my gaming test later on, so stay tuned for that. Now, speaking of the RAM, the configuration of the RAM and storage is also different between both, which I'll put it on your screen for an easy reference. Then the storage speed on the Pro is a UFS 4.0 compared to version 3.1 on the non-Pro, and the RAM quality is also faster on the Pro variant as well. Then the software update as of the recording of this video are different, not by few patches but quite a difference, where the Pro is at 14.0.6 and the non-Pro is at 14.0.10. And here's where I find it quite confusing, because why is it that the non-Pro has the latest version compared to the Pro? Now, while both has the same Leica technology and profile and camera setup, the Pro can record up to 8K 24fps. So is that a deal breaker? Well, not for me, because I still don't plan on recording 8K video on my smartphone since it takes a huge file size. So unless you're planning on shooting the next Marvel blockbuster on your smartphone, you're all good. Now, I even took a photo side by side between both of the cameras, and since this has the Leica photographic styles, I've always been a fan of the Leica Vibrant when I used the Xiaomi 13, hence I've been using this mode all the way. And based on these images I've taken, it looks identical, especially on the dynamic range and the quality perspective. However, the Pro seems to nail portrait mode shots way better on the edges, especially in this particular image of the Sonos Roam speaker. Other than that, even with the difference of the shutter speeds when the pictures were taken, you have a pretty much same image. Then finally, the Pro has Wi-Fi 7, making it more future-proof compared to Wi-Fi 6 on the non-Pro. Again, not a huge deal breaker over here. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Like and subscribe for more content like this. Just kidding. Alright, now we know what the differences are. Let's talk about what makes these phones worth bragging about. Now, firstly is the display and the content consumption, as it is really something worth shouting about. Now, firstly, with this current position in the smartphone packing order, it is amazing how not only it has a very high refresh rate, but its display goes up really bright, up to 2600 nits of peak brightness, which is brighter than our Malaysia's ringgit exchange value's future. Now, this display is also a video consumption king, as it has Dolby Vision, HDR10+, and Dolby Atmos support for its speakers, even though it has just dual speakers. Next, let's talk about the gaming performance. Now, the good news is that both can handle games like a beast, and whether or not you go with the Pro or the non-Pro, you will be very satisfied with the gaming performance on both, even during a very long gameplay. And both devices are also IP68 rated, which is great for a smartphone within this range of the T series from Xiaomi. Then another thing that is really worth mentioning is our website at www.adamlobo.tv. Well, if you like a written version of this particular review and other reviews too, make sure to check that out. Links will be down below. And thank you very much in advance. Now, another important thing to highlight is both the softwares of the phone will be getting 4 years of Android updates and 5 years of security updates, something that a lot of non-flagship smartphones usually lack of, so that was great to know. And finally, the cameras on these two variants performed really well. Now, if you love the pictures that you saw in my review of the Xiaomi 13 flagships, you are going to love the images being produced on these two phones. Now, other than the images you saw earlier, you're gonna love how well the selfie images were produced too, thanks to its improved image processing. Now, the phones also did very well in the 4K video recording at 30fps, all thanks to the Leica Professional Optical Lens Coating that reduces glare during the day and also at night as well. Then this new camera interface is also really nice, very straightforward to go through each settings and the menu, way much easier. Then the dedicated focal length effects like the 35, 50 and 90mm lenses, And of course, the Leica filters are also a blessing to make your photo stand out compared to other smartphones. Now, as of the recording of this video, I did not have the official price yet, but of course, I will update the pricing and the variants available in the pinned comment below, but do let me know which variant that you would go for, the Pro or the Non-Pro, and check out my in-depth review of the Xiaomi 13 over here.